wasn't so much playing as it was, you know, I always enjoyed playing. Mm-hmm. And when I was on stage or in the studio, I always enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes I would get a little bit, you know,
frustrated.
Yeah, maybe frustrated and a little bit sick of everything else that was going on around us at the time. But I certainly wouldn't trade it for anything.
Right.
I have the experience of playing as an artist for myself,
mm-hmm.
and I have the experience of playing as an artist in a larger scope.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I enjoyed doing it. I enjoyed playing in both of those different forms.
Mm-hmm.
So I wouldn't say that I regret anything. Yeah, it was always interesting. It was always a bit more impersonal as far as a relationship with fans.
Mm-hmm.
Something that I missed from the bigger tours, but you know, we were proud of what we were doing.
Yeah, you were getting a lot of exposure too.
Yeah, and we wanted as many people to hear us as who wanted to hear.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think I don't know if it's more fans or different fans in those different arenas, because
mm-hmm.
We definitely toured with a lot of bands, you know, like Linkin Park, who we won't, you know, they're not, if you hear both of our music, maybe you wouldn't, you know, immediately think of us on the same
right.
bill, but it was nice to be able, on those bigger tours, to get, to try to get some new fans that maybe wouldn't really give us a try unless we were in front of their
yeah.
face. Yeah, it was fun. It's, you know, for me, it was a different experience. And it was, you know, something that I knew that it's a rare experience
yeah.
for, you know, not a lot of people. So I was always happy to do.
Grateful.
Yeah, I was always really grateful, really happy to do some things like
mm-hmm.
that. I think maybe the time we had played South by Southwest
mm-hmm.
is one of my favorites.
That's cool.
And we played there more than once, but I think it was the first time because, you know, things were happening very fast.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we had just started, and I don't even know if we had a record out at the
mm-hmm.
time. And just to see, like, the magnitude of something like that from playing local shows in New Jersey. Meet Chris Cornell
mm-hmm.
from Soundgarden.
Mm-hmm.
Soundgarden was around at, like, a very influential time in my life.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, those bands really shaped my love and interest for music.
Mm-hmm.
Meeting the guys from Less Than Jake and NOFX,
yeah.
you know, from obviously still like shaping my love for music.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when we broke up and decided to, you know, take a break and stop touring, it was more of a shock than anything else, because you know, I was very excited to, you know, move on with another chapter in my life, but, you know, it was all I had known for 8 years. So at the same time, you know, it was definitely, you know, just a change.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, a change that I was really excited about at the time. And I'm still really excited about now.
Yes.
Everything has been really good.
Yeah, and you're moving on to bigger and better things, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
That's nice.
I at least like to think I am. So.
Yeah. That's cool.
Yeah. No, not really. I mean, it was, you know, we each had different ideas, and maybe we weren't on the same page, but we never had any problems with even like yelling, let alone violence.
Yeah.
We were never, we're all very level-headed people.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
We would talk,
mm-hmm.
not ever let our emotions get the best of
mm-hmm.
us.
Try to.
I have some friends in bands that play in New York, so I definitely try to get out to as many shows as I can.
Yeah.
I just saw 4 Years Strong.
Oh, nice.
Who I love. I started looking out for myself today. It's hard to tell. Like I was saying before, I think I've really liked the change in the actual music. And I think that will coincide with more people, you know, hearing about bands and actually maybe paying for music digitally. I think there are a lot of really interesting new business models, and I think that, you know, saying it's too early to say that, you know, the music industry is declining or devastated.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's more of a transition than anything else. And I look forward to, you know, more of a equilibrium in the business.
Yeah.
But I think that we're getting there.